High five. All right, buddy. Here you go.
Just a minute, guys. I'm almost done. I got to throw him some shorts on and maybe a shirt. And then we'll be ready to keep playing, guys. Be right back. Super pee diaper.
Yeah, this is a fun game.
Come here. Come here. We gotta get dressed. Kyle. Come here. There we go. Here we go. Come here. Kyle. Hey, hold on. Hold on. Right, give me one leg. Oh. Give me the other leg. All right. I'm almost ready. Give me five. All right. There's your drink. Right there.
Yo, what's up? Hello?
What's up?
Yep, I'm still here giving my son a banana, guys. Banana time! Here you go, Kyle. Wash, wash, wash. Let me throw this banana peel away, and I will be right back with more Ark.
Ouch. I just got ripped apart by torpedoes.
Okay. Are there any questions, guys? Any at all? Oh, I didn't realize if you didn't, off topic. Do you know where my wallet is? I can't find it. Darinus, too, go check that spot. You know, your wallet's over by the thingamajig, by the whatchamacallit. Should be underneath that doohickey.
Yeah, I didn't see a raffle going either.
Yeah, I left it without a timer open for anyone to enter for so long, and then I didn't realize I actually had to close it. I thought it was just open, and then when I drew a winner, I thought it just like ended, but it didn't. So I had to actually close the raffle and then end and then reset that raffle because I already drew a winner for that raffle.
Gotcha.
Yeah, that was 4,000 GC. It's only going up, guys. It's only going up from there. So stick around, have fun, and we're gaining 5 times the GC. You gain 5 GC every minute, 5 while we are online, and 5 GC every 10 minutes that we are offline, you know, doing the hosting thing. Because guys, I love hosting other streamers due to the fact that, yeah, I'm not online. Guess what? I've got a bunch of interest, and my community picked over 40 people, guys. So guess what? There's a lot of streamers to choose from and hang out with, and people are online throughout the entire day. My bot hosts randomly out of the people who are online out of my giant list. Basically, you guys could find new streamers or new interests through this setup that I have. I left it like that because throughout an entire 24 hours, there's at least one streamer streaming at some point throughout the day. So this gives you guys an idea of people I've checked out, people the community has checked out, and we just keep adding to it. So don't you worry, guys. Don't you worry. There's always going to be something new here on the stream. Hell, even in conversation. Exclamation GC, Mini. It's so much easier.
Thank you.
No problem, man.
As you can see, I have some issues when I'm still waking up.
Dude, you've been waking up for like the past 10 hours. I've been streaming for the past 16.
Yeah. Went to sleep, or when I went to sleep, Blood Crow is still streaming. And I thought he was doing a full 24, so I left my host up, and it was offline when I came on.
Yeah, this is... I don't know what the fuck's going on. We have a private server for 40 playable people, and we still don't have access to it yet.
For 40 people?
Yeah. It Damn. Will be upgraded as time goes on, guys. It's upgradable easily. This was started by Blood Crow and Borderland Games. Borderland Games community literally paid for us to have the server for the first month free. Just one guy came out of nowhere, said, awesome streams. You guys have been around for a long time to keep us happy. Here's $50 for the server. That's the first month for 50 people, guys. That's the first month. That's insane. And then more people donated. And then more people donated. We've raised $117. This isn't just my server. This isn't just Blood Crow's. This is mine, Blood Crow's, Borderland Games, Deceptive Cobras, any other streamers that are deciding to get in access. It quite literally is exclamation Ark server, if you guys want to know more about it. It takes you straight to the game server's clan page. Like, we don't even touch the money. It goes straight to the server. That's how awesome this is. I'll even pull it up, guys. I'll run the command.
You forgot Black's 4,000.
Oh, my bad, Black Mage. Bam. You want to donate to the community-ran clan server? Go here and help out. All money goes directly to the server site, no one else. That link should take you straight to the clan donation page. It's amazing. Like, bam, I pulled it up. You'll see a page just like this. Just like
yeah,
that.
Saying
look at that.
Pending install in Dallas right now.
Yeah, we were waiting for them to install it. It's crazy. Look at that. And $50 is 1 month at 50 people. 500
is it
up
only
to
PayPal?
50 to 500, huh?
Is it only PayPal?
I don't know. I just know it's via PayPal.
Okay.
But this is straight up for the Ark private server. So, guys, we're trying to plan a little fun with the tribe war. So, yeah. That's what our plan is.
No, I'll definitely get involved. For sure.
Yeah, it's crazy, guys. I'll be with Blood Crow's server. I'll be with Blood Crow's clan for a while. The other thing is eventually, can anyone do the bank heist? Yes, Gamer Plus Pro. Anyone can do it. It does have a cooldown. It's like a minute or 5 minutes or something. It does have a minimum cooldown that I cannot take off. So I think it's like every 30 seconds to 5 minutes, somewhere in there. I don't know what it is. I don't remember what it is. But yes, you guys can, anyone can bank heist. Anyone can start the bank heist and anyone can join it. Remember, every 10 people is a level. So when we start getting tons more people, I'll be bumping up the gaps between levels, because with each successful level entry, there's a higher chance, or there's a lower chance in winning, but a higher win rate. I have it set to as high as 3 times the GC you put in. And the chances at winning three times your GC, because someone can drop, like, you can drop any amount, up to 5,000 total. That's everyone.
It says 5 million.
Or, yeah, 5 million. When we hit 5 million in the people adding, you know, into the bank heist, I will take that cap off forever. So that is a progress achievement there. You know, if we hit 5 million in the bank heist that people are putting into bank heist, I will just take the cap off and it'll be unlimited bank heist amount forever. So if you got 20 million, there you go. You can play with 20 million all at once. The first level is with 10 people or less. That is a chance of 54 or 55% win chance. So have fun, guys. You get a 1.5% chance, too, of your winnings. 1.5% of your winnings. So definitely have fun and hang out with that. The last level is either, I believe, 33 to 35% chance to win, which is a level 5. That's 50-plus people. I may up that winning because its win ratio is so low, but those who do win have a high chance of, or not a high chance, but a high win rate. I just don't know how it'll affect because I scaled it to as high as that. Nice. Mini, you're out.
Yeah, I died on that one.
Are you having fun?
Thank you.
My son's having fun. You want to see what I see? Check this out. I got the greatest son ever. Is that cool stuff, buddy? Kyle? Kyle? Is that cool?
Nice.
All right, time to get back to the game. Don't worry, Black Mage, I'm adding it right this second. Bam, Black Mage, go ahead and check. Boom! What up?
Yo, man.
Hey, Bloodcry, I haven't left yet. I haven't got off or gone to bed.
I went ahead and let the kids stay on for about 2 hours just now, so you wouldn't be
crying. We still don't have access to the server. You might want to give them a call.
Yeah, I know, I see it. I already sent a ticket in.
Morning, Crow.
I sent a ticket in last night, dude.
Yeah, I know. So. And 2 days on the second, they basically are saying they're... If you look at the reported issues, basically they don't have access to the game yet.
What, gameservers.com?
Yeah, basically they're stating they don't have access to the game and that they'll be getting they'll be fixing the issue shortly. This was 2 days ago, like the second. But yet game server's the only site with this clan pay. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Which is pretty jacked
up.
Well,
that's dumb, dude. That is dumb. Why would they even put it on here that they have it if they can't deliver it? They've never done that before.
Crow.
Yeah.
I'll be contributing as soon as I can.
Awesome. I mean, it sucks. I mean, the only other thing to do would be like to, well...
I would say give them... I would honestly say, Blood Crow, give them a personal call. It is business time now in Dallas. And they should have basically been fixing this, like, not that long ago. And the reported issue was on the 2nd, so it should be fixed by now. I mean, the game is out. Not to mention, obviously, Steam... Because game servers caps out at 70 players. What are all the servers capped out on the official servers? 70 players. So yeah, they're using game servers. But they're saying that, I was looking at Ark when I clicked it. They basically showed all these different servers. But it was like, it was stating that those were demo servers, and that the official servers for to test the game were not hosted by game servers, but they were given to game servers by another party, which is like really weird. It was like, why would a server have another server's access if they didn't host the official login to the game in the alpha stages, you know what I mean? Or hell, they didn't host any access to the official stages. You're like what, level 25? On Vidon?
Yeah.
I'm 19, I'm getting close. Oh yeah, and I finally made a bed in my cave, and I came across a supply drop that I could access, and it had wood furnishings, and I forgot that we can just choose everything we want as Engram, because eventually blueprints will be accessible, because I have a blueprint for wood ceiling. And yet, I didn't learn it. But I can make it as long as the blueprint is in my inventory. And I use it as an item.
Well, evidently about... Oh, your customer. 2 minutes ago. Okay, right as I was typing them up. Okay, so... Supposedly they should. It's up.
What?
It's literally up.
I need the info.
Nope, you're not getting it. Can't do it.
I've been up all night doing this.
Nope. Dude, how funny is it? The moment that I come in here, it's down, and it's up now.
Yeah,
how fucking funny is it?
All right, I'm ready whenever you want to send that info, Bloodcrow.
Let me see.
Guys, we have our server. We have our own private server, finally. I will gladly leave VDON and come back from time to time, but I want on this server to play forever.
Bam, there's a server.
All right, I'm going to go put my body in the cave.
I got to see if Border's on. I'm pretty sure he's not, but I got to find him. Hold on. Okay, evidently he's not up yet. Okay, so...
Yeah, Blood Crow. Mm-hmm. It's fucking awesome. I created 3 more chests with gear. Because I put the wooden floor down, I can't access the 2 chests around it. But when we become tribesmen, you guys can automatically have access to this cave, which I'm excited about. Alright, I'm leaving this server to jump into the real private server we will be playing on from now until basically the end of time.
Alright, let me put on here server height and update my status. My ass is about to go live now. That is ironic. I'm sorry. That is just freaking ironic. We were like, oh yeah, just go to sleep and you wake up, it'll be up, right? Yeah, and as soon as I come in here, it's like, ah. It's so troll. I swear to God, it's not like I had them on speed dial. I was like, dude, wait till I get up in the morning so he'll stay up all night. No. That is funny. Don't you agree? Yeah. Yeah. All right. You go ahead here. Looks like everything should be up, I believe. Yeah, everything should be up and running on my screen. So. It says it's active, dude. I'm waiting for it to pop up on my favorites list right now. I see the IP.
Still going for over 24 hours. Still going for, so far, 16 and a half hours, Blood Crow. I'm good. I'm ready to go after the first 24. I'm good. I'm doing this shit.
Alright guys, just so you know, I'm on both both Twitches, so it gives both of you a viewer.
Awesome, dude. Appreciate it. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to make sure that the server is up. I see the IP. I've done added it. It says server not responding. Was there any updates? I bet you there was at least one update. There had to have been, at least while I was asleep. Hold on, let me pull it up.
Okay, I've got to exit.
Yeah, those are 40 meg update. I'm not surprised. Okay, so.
Yeah. Okay.
Minikai. Yeah, dude, man, this sucks, man. I was hoping to do this last night, dude. I literally would have stayed. If this server would have came up last night, I would have gotten that reburst of energy I would have needed.
Okay.
But it just didn't happen.
How do I... Okay, add server. That's what I wanted. That's the IP. No password.
Yeah, no password.
No password. Okay.
Yeah, it's super simple, dude. To upgrade to 50 players. So.
Okay. I'm not seeing our server yet. I added it to my favorites.
Yeah, give it a second. Give it a second.
Are you in it yet?
Yeah. Just give it a second. No, I'm not in it yet. No. Edit host name.
Oh, you're giving it a name and everything?
Well, I mean, I could. I mean, it's just called 40 Player Ark Survival Evolved. I'll wait till Border gets on, and we'll come up with some kind of a name. I wouldn't say the Coalition, but I mean, that would actually be more like Co-Carnage, you know?
Yeah.
We'll we'll figure something out to actually call the server, but I'm trying to see if I can put a password on it.
Restless Gaming?
No, I wouldn't do that.
Can you change the name whenever you want?
Yeah. That requires a server restart, I believe, but yeah.
Okay, that's not a big deal. You know, a server restart, it's like whatever.
Unless when you restart it, it goes down.
Yeah. That's pretty much it right there, man, in a nut basket.
Alright, so I'm chilling.
Yeah, I used to have admin privileges during like Call of Duty 4 and stuff like that, and I did a server rotation restart, and the server crashed.
I don't know why they're having problems with the server getting up. I mean, that's just ridiculous. Game services, like, I'll be honest with you, I mean, their customer support is not like 100%, they're more like 70, you know, on average.
Yeah.
Still better than Comcast, but they I had to say it, dude. The only reason why their service, customer service, isn't good at Comcast anymore is because I'm not there.
Not to toot your own horn or anything.
Yeah, not to toot my own horn, but more like a vacuum cleaner. Okay, it's that awesome. But yeah, the I don't know. We're gonna see.
Out of curiosity, do we have a group for World of Warships?
Honestly, I mean, I don't know. Hold on.
We don't have, like, an official group, but there is one in the TeamSpeak, yes.
What's up, Black Mage? Yeah, we got the server. It literally just came up, but we're adding it, and we're trying to get it to actually show up in the server list so we can actually join it.
I'm hoping this don't take a couple of hours.
Restart server, press OK. Please have 5 to 10 seconds. And we're going to see if it'll get it going. All right.
It's trying to find a game at this address.
Yeah, I restarted it, dude. So it went down.
Did it. That's awesome, my son. Woohoo! They did it. That's awesome. I love that. Because they, like, managed to do something in the show.
Alright, yeah, I'm just seeing what, Alright. Come on, show up.
Oh, man. Hey, Blood Crow.
Yeah.
You unhosted, right?
Yeah, one.
What the hell? I actually have 18 real people in the chat? That's friggin' awesome. That's... Oh, my people are leaving. Oh. Okay, wow, you're black screening. Are you loading into Vedan?
I'm just chilling here. Yeah, I'm just chilling here. And, just chilling until the damn server comes up, because I'm actually watching the server, and as soon as it comes up, I'm joining ours. Like mine, yours, and
Spike
birds,
Munchie,
so,
I'll never quit you. No, come back! Okay, well, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get my son some drink, and I'll be right back. Sound like a plan?
Okay.
All right, be right back, guys.
I got to get him some drink.
Okay. Should we take... What's up, Stuart? Yeah, man, I'm... Not sure in TeamSpeak just now. Was you not in TeamSpeak?
Yeah.
Oh, no. He said he was in game. We have the IP for the server. We're waiting for it to officially come up. I've got the IP address, so I don't want to give it out just right now because it's not actually registering just yet. But it is showing that the status is active and not pending no more.
Get up there, buddy.
And I see the server.
Get on the couch.
So, like, right now, we're kind of just in a limbo status, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah. But we're just kind of waiting for the server damn thing to come up. How about that?
Anything?
Waiting for the damn thing to come up.
Yeah, Blood Crow? What's it say on their end?
Nothing yet.
No, I mean, like, does it say, like, installing or updating or anything?
Well, that was the pending status.
And their response for that was what? Like, it's all good and ready to go now? 100%?
Yeah, that it should be up just in a few minutes, and literally it was up within a few minutes, so...
No, Gamer Plus Pro, if you're killed in the heist, you're not done for the rest of the day. You're literally just waiting for the cooldown of the heist. I think it's like 5 minutes minimum. Is that what it is, Blood Crow? Or is it like a minute? I can't remember.
You should have like a 1 or 2 minutes to actually enter into the bank heist.
No, for when it's over.
Oh, Stuart, no, I can't hear you, dude. Say something else in chat, in TeamSpeak.
Can you hear me?
Oh, there we go. All right, there you go. There you are. I thought I saw you in here. I knew I wouldn't, you know. Man, whatever. Man, I've only got like probably about 4 hours of sleep, so it wasn't much better than just staying up all damn night anyway, but it was a little bit of an eye rester, so.
How you doing, man? Dude, you know who would be cool to get on here? Frickin' Roshu. I know Friday's been here. Russlum said this game looked pretty good, but I guess like tons of people in Russlum's channel were like, in the stream were bashing the game like it's terrible, it doesn't run, and all this crazy stuff. And I bet you it's all those crybabies with Titans.
Well, dude, you gotta understand, man, this game's only been out for
like 3 days.
Yeah, a few days. Not that much at all. A few freaking days. They have to give them time to fix the bugs and the issues. These people have never probably beta or alpha tested a game in their life. I have beta and alpha tested games that were your only invite. You couldn't even buy into them when I was younger.
Quite literally just recently. World of Warships. We're still in it. And you're an Albion, for crying out loud.
What do you guys think? Should I research the next cruiser, or should I go with a destroyer?
What level?
It'd be tier 2.
Tier 2.
Japanese.
Destroyer if you want torpedoes. The cruisers are a little bit better. They have decent guns. They still have really good torpedoes. The guns are a little bit better than destroyers. So, but just remember this, though. A tier 10 Japanese cruiser for now is under testing, and you can actually get health regen on it.
Oh, it actually has health regen?
Yeah, like you can actually press that repair button and it'll pop your health.
Oh my goodness. Wow.
Yeah, American cruisers at 9 and 10 both get it as well. So.
Yeah, but they made American cruisers like powerful as fuck.
Yep.
And I went cruiser and destroyer on both.
I've done every side. Carriers, destroyers, cruisers, BBs. I still prefer the Japanese stuff.
Yeah. I've not done the carriers really. I really do not like the playstyle. How it's an overhead view and a little better detail than the regular map. I hate that. I'd rather be all up in my face with the action. Cruisers and destroyers for the reload times, battleships for the huge tank force, and they do some serious damage on the higher tiers. Lots of damage.
Some more.
Let's hang out.
So, right now, what I'm doing is...
some more?
Keep an eye on these tickets and stuff, okay? As soon as something changes, I will let you know.
All right, I'm going to jump back on VDON.
Awesome.
Hold on, buddy.
Some more.
Here's my son. Some more, like... Hold on, buddy. I know you eat. Let me load in. See where I'm at. I should still be in the cave. Let me get some actual real food for you. And we'll go from there, okay, buddy? At some point, I'm going to have to slow my son down from eating. So that way he has, like he already ate a full banana. He ate a cake donut that was cinnamon. He wants more because it was a cake donut. I see you over there on your stream, just like, damn it, we want our server. Holy fuck, Blood Crow, you're up to 54 people right now. What the fuck, dude? I need that kind of viewership. I'm not gonna lie.
It's been happening every time I get on now, just about. Like, I get a good, like, rush of people in. I've already done... Did I do my Steam thing yet? No, I did not. Hold on.
Wow.
Community... No, wait. Yeah, that's right. Schedule an event. Okay, and we're going to say server height. Waiting for login.
Carriers on World of Warships is just like the artillery load tanks. You can play artillery.
Doing the same on mine.
Carriers.
Oh shit, Virtual Freedom streaming. Hold on.
Who's Virtual Freedom?
Virtual Freedom is the guy working on that new bot. And he says if he ever is streaming, it's a test to mod. I gotta see this. But he's testing out his bot. Yeah, he's building a bot that may actually replace DeepBot, and it's going to be free.
That sounds like something we both want.
Yeah, because I love DeepBot, but I can't keep paying money to it because I don't have the money for it. You know what I'm saying?
So, I feel your pain. I feel your pain.
He's streaming under City Skylines with Flamer Forces.
You said virtual freedom?
Yeah.
How is it spelled? Oh, all I virtual see is World freedom. Of Warships. Two separate words or what?
All together.
Okay, he's streaming World of Warships?
Yeah. Now he says it's playing World of Warship.
Yeah, and I see Probot in the background.
Yep.
That's hilarious. That's what it's going to look like?
I believe so, yeah, dude.
Oh my god, I'm excited. All I see is view, project, build, debug, team, tools, test, .NET reflector.
Yeah. Alright.
$2 hookers for everyone. I love his title right now.
What is this? Marvel Heroes 2nd birthday. Yep.
Yeah, I'm going to stick in chat, but I got to go pay rent. Spike Munchie's going to... My OBS broke. Oh, Spike Munchie. Damn. He's going to hang out in the chat, but he's got to go pay rent. All right, we're going. We're going to get some... We're getting some right now, okay?
Thanks, dude.
Be right back.
Yeah, that title is awful.
Damn.
That is awful.
That's virtual freedom. Just
you're
catching...
You're going to get absolutely annihilated here in a second, I think. That shit deranged him in an American battlecruiser.
Be right back. You hear a virtual freedom mm-hmm. talking trash about himself? He's like, yeah, I'm gonna get destroyed right now. Because I'm in an American battlecruiser. Alright, I gotta get my son some food before he freaks out. Be right back.
Just dump on him. There we go, that. Look at that, I got like 2K. It's
snowing right now.
Anthony.
Huh?
I just got in the server.
What? Really?
I'm joking.
Like.
That would have been fun. You would have been like, you gotta wait, boy. You gotta wait.
I would have literally just. Like, I'm over here refreshing on the side. Oh, it's... Oh, my God, the game crashed. Fuck. Ark crashed. What? Be right back, guys. Be right back.
All right. Hold on.
How's blood go down this morning?
You want me a butter sandwich? Peanut butter sandwich? Or another banana? Banana? One banana? Pew, pew. Look,
on, baby.
Look, it's a gun.
There we go.
Alright, what do you want, buddy?
Come on, it fucking nailed the shit out of that guy.
I can't give you donuts.
Oh, we got an arc server. Nice.
Here you go. That's it. I'm not giving you two.
Did he order from somewhere, or did he be installing his own?
Sandwich? Peanut butter and jelly? Yeah. All right, get on the couch, and I'll bring it. Get on the couch, buddy. Yeah.
Oh, this is good.
All right. Peanut butter sandwich for the win.
What's up, Norway? Yeah, we got our server up, bro, but it's not actually working. So, yeah. We got a server. Wait, what is this?
Oh man, American Battleships is just awful.
Oh, 0 minutes ago.
Well, with the way they nerfed AG, I mean, you think it's still good?
Yeah, guys, this is Virtual Freedom in the background. He's the one building that new thing. I'm waiting for the server to get up so we can log in.
And look at the accuracy of this fucking cruiser. Really? It's like they have goddamn just fucking throwing knives, dude. I feel like I'm throwing spoons at people. That's what I feel like. Honestly, it's just like I'm throwing a spoon. How's the spoon doing?
Alright, hold on, guys. I'm making my son a sandwich. I'm making a bagel real fast.
Oh, it's Blood Crow.
Then
what's
we'll be
up,
playing
dude?
Some more Ark, guys. Ew. That was a nasty butter knife.
Well, since you're here, if you want, I'll show you the bot. Are you interested in seeing that? I take it by that you mean yes. Alright.
Yeah.
Well, you're looking at the code. I mean, some of it. Essentially, that's what all this shit is. No, I've been working on it, actually.
I'm checking out a new bot, guys. Here, go give this guy a follow. It's in my channel if you want to. You don't have to, but he's working on a bot that he's going to give out to people, and I might end up being one of the first people to get it, along with probably Game Key once it's released.
So I can get it out of the way so it's not blocking everything. It's kind of confusing because it's all black.
All right, the server better be up in a second or two. It should be.
There you go. Okay. So, this is more or less what it looks like. This right here, you'll be able to get your off key. So, if like, let's say I delete this, I can go in. This pops up, and then you can get your off key. You'll just put in your information, whatever it is, and so let's say bot. And then, I think that's it. You'll notice that it's blank. Click login, and then it'll actually do the rest. See, there's your off key. It gets it for you. Just like same as the DeepBot does. And so this will be the Twitch user login, same as that. DeepBot, same idea. The overlay, this right here, that's part of the overlay that I showed you, so you can call it whatever. You call it Blood Crows Overlay. And then you can create yourself an overlay. So here you have an overlay. It's completely resizable, however big you want it. And the cool thing about this is that if you bring in, let's say, an image. I really should make a video of this. I don't know why I don't. Anyway, let's go to Dropbox. You have images, right, icons, PNGs. Okay, so we'll just take one of these images here. And we can drag and drop it in. Yeah, I don't really care. I can always generate another one. Alright, so you'll be able to drop it in, and now what you can do is you can actually resize this to any size you want. So I can have it huge, like that, or I can make it small, just like this. So, you know, I can have something that you can pick up with OBS, per se, and then just cut out the picture, part of the picture that you want, and this will be a see-through overlay, which will be nice. And you can make as many of these as you want. What it'll actually do is it'll actually save the location, save the size, save everything on your screen. So if you have like multiple monitors, you can just keep it up there and you can just use it as different icons for your streaming to make it nice and easy to use, and you know, you have some cool pictures on your stream. I just thought that would be an easy way to do it. So this is that. Let me get rid of this. Hold on.
This bot looks cool so far, guys.
Yeah, it looks neat.
Oh, look at that. He's got his ranking system at the bottom and a multiplier.
Hey,
Manny. Wow, that is cool. Each rank has a multiplier.
Alright, so that's the overlay. Use your point system just like it is in DeepBot, no different.
Trying to forget about the damn Ark server for a minute. So,
We go to the chat. Chat will be here. You can actually be able to show chat from different user groups. So if you have users or your followers or your mods or your donors, let's say you don't want to listen to users because you don't like users. I don't know.
Here we go, guys.
And let's say you don't want to hear from your mod because you have a maybe
on
Skype
back.
Or something, so you can turn that off.
Dude, this
so
bot
you can
is
actually
awesome.
Narrow it down
pretty
to
cool. He's going over right now.
Be what you want. see, so you're not seeing a whole bunch
Master
of chat.
Master Coach, thank you for that host, my friend. Hell
you
yeah.
You have the hide command, so you won't be seeing people put in, like, you know, exclamation point, you know, raffle help or something. That'll be this option right here. Mentions only. What it'll do is it'll only highlight people who mention your name. It'll be like, hey, look, you know, so-and-so said this, so you only have stuff talking to you. Colorize the names in chat if you want to. We can alternate the colors. Colorize the text, same deal. Use timestamps just so you can see when people talk, and then you can have highlight mentions, so you can actually highlight the background of it, so you can actually see things that are just talking to you. So it's kind of like mentions only, but a little bit different if you want to see everything, but just highlight mentions. That'll do that. We have raffles. Same deal as DeepBot. You'll be able to keep an inventory of your past winners, so you can see who won what and when, so you're not giving out multiple beta codes, like let's say for World of Warships. You're not giving out multiple beta codes to multiple, you know, the same person over and over again. You want to, you know, kind of negate that. You have your current entries. This will be the people who do it. Obviously, get winner, start, reset. That's pretty obvious. You can make it available, the raffle options, to only certain people. Let's say you just want to do it to your users or your followers or the people who donated to you. Donated subscribers are all going to be kind of lumped into one, because that's, I think, a better way to do it. Just because you don't want to differentiate between...
Here we go.
The people who give you money, you know, they're the people who give you money, and you'd be like, hey, look, you give me money, so that's where we want to keep you. I might set a limit on what you can consider a donator, so someone can't just donate $1 and then get into the donator crowd. That's kind of stupid. That kind of defeats the whole purpose, but you something you can do. Well, the raffle types, obviously, keyword auction ticket, that's all the same as DeepBot. Keyword raffle name, so instead of just someone coming in and typing exclamation point raffle, you could type in, like, exclamation point, blood crow, or, you know, blood raffle, or something, whatever you want to do. You can put the item here in chat. And the idea here is that I want to make a queue system, so you don't actually have to deal with, you know, every 10 minutes setting up a fucking raffle, because that's annoying as shit. You can actually set it up before your stream, a list of raffles, you know, let's say you want to do a raffle for 10 minutes, and you want to take a break for 10 minutes, and then you want to do a raffle for 10 minutes, and then it's going to handle all of that. And what the idea behind here is that people are actually going to put in a claim code, so they can be able to claim their item, their prize. If they won something, then it'll keep track of who won, obviously, because that's what the past winners does. And they'll be able to type exclamation point claim, and so you can actually beforehand set it all up, and I'll show you here in a second. The auto raffle, this isn't done yet, but we're working on it. The auto raffle, so when they type claim, it'll actually send them a Twitch message with the information that you've already preset into the raffle, so you can not have to deal with it. I mean, personally, I don't want to, like, have to pump raffle, like, hey, we're doing the raffle, hey, we're doing the raffle. Like, it's just going to automatically do all that shit for you. And here's the time between raffles and the max claim time. So you can say, let's, you know, someone's there, you say, type claim, they have to type claim in chat, they have a minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, whatever you want them to have. So that's...
This sounds awesome, Blood Crow.
We have alerts where you're going to announce in chat or not, because honestly, I don't know about announcing in chat.
Here's what I told you about. He's got a music bot over there, and
you have an alert file.
Cool.
This will be
spam and chat filter,
right now,
which
it'll be
DeepBot
going
don't
to
have.
MP3 or Wave of your choice.
Oh, yeah, this will be a brand new bot that I'll pick it up right away.
Auction raffle, keyword raffle, these are all the same. It's just DeepBot, no big deal. You have Arena. This will be the arena. You're going to be able to add text.
Look at that. Look at that.
You were talking
he's putting some of the stuff in. I asked.
About doing setting up your own text for this stuff. You're going to be able to do this here. You're going to have a custom mode or a normal mode. And, you know, the normal mode will be just one that's automatically generated. Then you can have a custom mode, and this information panel will change, and you'll be able to set up your own arena. So instead of having.
I see that total ranking
arena,
system down there on
the
bottom.
The Gladiator Sanctum or something crazy like that. And then you can make up your own, you know, I don't know, text for it and give it its own story. Bank Heist, same deal. Bank Heist won't necessarily be called a Bank Heist unless you want it to be. Again, you can set up your own story. You can call it, you know, the different weapons. You can say where you're raiding, all that other stuff. Or you can even say, like, hey, we're going to go kill this dragon. You know, let's see, get some loot. This is kind of the same idea. Something you mentioned yesterday that I kind of like. The race, that's fairly obvious. It's going to be just like the DeepBot race. We're going to have a quiz bot, so people can do quizzes. And if you want to add your own quiz stuff to it, that's going to be here, so you can have questions and answers. And that's a mini game that your people can play while they're in chat. You also have roulette. I saw this on another channel, and I really liked it. You can do, like, you know, black or something, and then
that
you
is
can
cool.
bet points. So
that is cool.
Game to add to the
that is cool.
User screen. music, kind of the same deal as Deepbot, but what we're going to do also with the music is we are going to add MP3s. So you can have your own MP3s in your own folder and add those. People can request songs, request your MP3s, now along with doing the YouTube thing. So, you know, if you want to just say listen to only your songs, but you want to give people the ability to request songs that you have, the MP3s are going to come into play. For that, you look down here, request cost for cost. This is all kind of the same as Deepbot. Events, we're gonna have a list of commands where you're gonna have to be able to set your OBS file that's gonna work with the CLR, so you can actually put in a command and be like, you know, penis, and then show a big dick on your screen or something if you want
to. That's hilarious.
Will this remove large files between multiple?
Drina's 2, not yet, man, not yet. Me and Bloodcrow has it up. But we can't, we're waiting for the server to hit, like, become completely live.
The idea here is that we're gonna keep everything local. You're going to keep your database local. You're going to keep your sound files. You're going to keep everything fucking local. So all you got to do is just copy it over, and boom, you're done. That's it. I don't like how some people have, namely Deepbot, has all the information online. Because if Deepbot goes down, you're fucked. Or if, let's say, Deepbot stops doing what they're doing, you're fucked. I'm making it everything
local.
What
he's saying is
much
that you're,
because
just
I want
like
you
Deepbot
to have
is,
any information. And if I ever
instead of having to pay you everything,
doing,
like you are the server.
Matter.
So
you have everything.
Just like
you're
going to
have
doing
all the old information.
Yeah, what if the Deepbot server itself goes down?
Exactly.
All right, so the command list here, you can do the OBS file. This is going to work with the CLR. Again, so you can put a big dick on your screen if you want to when you type penis. Then your alert file, you can have it, you know, scream penis if you want to. Yeah,
like I said, guys, you never know what you're going to hear on this channel.
Your own list. The rank availability, we'll get to this, is actually going to change a little bit because you're going to set your own ranks up and you're going to be able to have people use them. I'm not sure if I want to change it yet or not, partially because if you start adding ranks, you could have someone with 40 ranks. Do you really want to have 40 rank availability to this? It's kind of a pain in the ass. So,
you can add
prefix,
your own rank?
You notice that we have a bunch of different keys that you can use. The reason I'm doing this is and having a keyword prefix is because we don't want everyone to be the same. You know, I don't want everyone to be able to go in and go raffle help. You know, we're trying to combat bots here. You know, people get a list of commands if they want, but you know, the idea here is that we don't want people just to come in and go raffle help and then oh no raffle and leave. That's stupid. Or you know, or they flood it, or they see a raffle and they flood the channel with bots trying to win. It's not something I want to do. So that was kind of what we used to help combat that. Notifications. This is the welcome joins. You know, just so you can announce to people like, hey, you know, so and so's here. If
that is
follower,
cool,
etc. I think I
that's
might
really cool.
And put in where you can set your own with your own ranks that I'll be showing you in a second. You'll be able to set up your own announcements too.
Wow.
This again over here is your notifications for followers, subscribers, donators. And this will be, again, a link to an OBS file, an alert file. What I want to do is, in the CLR file, is I want to make it so you can show, like, the last five, you know, if you want to put five here, for instance. You can show the last five followers. If you want to show the last five, or last 10 subscribers, you can show the last 10 subscribers. So it'll just scroll across the screen. And then if you want to do the donators, you can show however many donators. And then you can even show the top donator. So whoever, because it's going to be a cumulative total. So you can say, let's say, you know, I came into your channel for the last 2 years, and every month I donated $20. Now, what it's going to show is that I donated $480, so they'll actually show the max donation instead of just for that month or something else. The idea here is that you're going to get a max, so people actually can see. You know, if you have someone who's been loyal to you and spending a lot of money, you want to show them.
That's kind of cool.
Channel. That's the idea. Instead of someone just coming
like
in and like,
hey,
I
popped and dropped $500.
Cent.
Yeah.
You're saying that if I use that top donators count,
commercials,
it'll, if she adds like 500, if she comes in and adds another 50, it'll be 500. If she comes in next month and adds 100, it'll be 600. It'll
have
a ring for the whole time until someone beats her.
Right here. Just
oh my
so
God!
It's
what?
Easier for you to navigate through what dates, times, etc.
Oh my God!
And you want to make highlight reels for YouTube or whatever.
That highlight setting is awesome.
This is going to be the location of different things like MP3s, logs, custom icons like the icons down here. You're going to see here. This is the icon folder that I have. These icons are actually images on my computer. They're just a folder full of images. Users here. This is the part that I kind of like. We're gonna be able to search users. Obviously, this will be what this is. You can, let's say you just want to look at just the followers only. You can just pull up followers only, or subscribers only, or donators only, whatever you want to do. Searchability here, user count, obviously pretty self-explanatory.
Later, gamer, gamer yourself, plus pro man. Later, bro.
Here. Now, don't just ignore this, because that's not going to matter. But you're going to be able to set icons, you're going to be able to set ranks, you're going to be able to set the type of AR.
What's up, Blackie?
So you can have, you know, either followers or whatever. And the idea here is that you're going to make, let's say, monthly, you have followers, right? This text is going to change depending on what type they are. But month, let's say, you know, it's a follower, so it's monthly. You can actually, you know, assign ranks for every month. So, like, first month, you're a plebe. Next month, you're, I don't know, a donkey. I don't know. Whatever you want to do. You can add whatever you want. And the idea here is that as people come to your screen, stream, donate money, subscribe, whatever, you know, that they're going to be able to rank up. So they can look to see... Yeah, it's going to be pretty nifty, I think. And so they're going to be able to see, you know, how they're doing. And then it also discriminates between, you know, the people who just show up and the people that, you know, have been there a long time. Again, the reward system that I'm kind of going for, because you want people to come back to the channel. You want people to donate. You want people to...
This guy sounds like my kind of guy, Blood Pro.
In your stream.
Oh, he's cool. He's been on my channel for the last couple days.
And then
days.
Here, this is the really cool thing. Is this is the multiplier. All right, so you can give it multipliers depending on how you... You want them to get points. You want them to do a raffle, etc. So essentially what this is going to do is that as they rank up, you can increase the multiplier. This text obviously isn't changing. But
guys, we're looking at a new friggin' bot.
Multiplier, they'll actually have a better chance of winning items, right? So they can come in and they can... let's say you have 100 people. And you have 50... users and 50 followers. Okay, you can have the users are just a base of 1, but you have your followers, which is a base of 1.5. So you actually have instead of 100, you know, because it's 50 and 50, you actually have 125, because the users are accounting for 1.5 apiece instead of just 1. This actually gives people who follow a better chance to win your prizes. It'll give them more points, etc. And you can even do this as they rank up. So, you know, let's say you have a follower for, if you're a follower today, you get a 1.5 chance. If you're a follower for 3 months, you could have a 2 chance, a 2.0 chance, you know, something like that. Again, rewarding people who are in your channel, give a better chance of winning. You want to, how can I say this? You want to facilitate your users winning over other plebes who just joined the channel, follow that day, and then, unsubscribe. I didn't like that. I never liked that about Twitch. So if you can give your consistent followers, the people who actually, you know, help out your channel, a better chance of winning and other things, that's what this is going to do for you. Spam chat filters. This is kind of what we're going to add to help people from, you know, posting links or, you know, saying a bunch of racist shit in your channel or saying bad words. It'll automatically ban them. You know, I mean, depending on how you want to do it. So, you can have bad words.
Blood code, don't mind testing it.
And you can have your warn, mute, suspend, you know? Ban. Mm-hmm. Let's say your first one you want to warn them. Let's say, you know, you put your bad word filters on, bad phrase filters on. You want to replace lead speak, because if you're going to replace lead speak, you know, someone's typing penis with P3N1S, you know, it'll try to figure that out. And it'll delete the chat if you want it. So the first one will warn them for one.
You don't. Okay.
Hour. Okay, so if they do it again, you know, then
this is another ticket. I'm doing what I can, bro, to get the server up today when we're doing this.
Days. And then third offense, we're going to ban them for fucking 1 year.
1 year. Damn.
Why not?
He said 1 year, why not?
As long as they're in the system, then it starts ranking up on them. And that's how that works. So if they get out past the 1 hour, then they can do it again. You know, they can make a mistake, not a big deal. Spam options, same deal, same options, everything's about the same. Then you come down here, financial history. Now, this is where, this is what this does that nothing else does. And the deal here is that because you're keeping the financials on your system, like I was telling you earlier, game, you're going to actually have graphs and shit. So you can actually pull dates. So if you want to pull a date, say, from today to, or better yet, let's go from last month, the first of last month to the end of last month. you can pull a search. You can see how many followers you got last month. You can get how many donations. You can pull up the donations or subscriptions. So you can actually check to see how everything is going. Now, this is going to be like a kind of simple cheat sheet.
One-year bans are the shit.
Subscriptions will be, you know, a recent look of it. But you can actually pull and get all the pertinent data of, like, who's following, what donations you did those days. So you can actually review what you did on those streams to see if you can make more money. Yes, and it will be useful for taxes if you pay taxes. Some people don't, some people do. But yeah, you're going to be able to pull all of your financials. That's the whole idea behind it. But the problem that you're going to see with the taxes is that it's not going to show the money getting taken out, okay? It's only going to show the full financial. So you wouldn't really want to use it for taxes, because PayPal is going to give you a better of what it looks like. Because after let's say I donate $5 to you, right? PayPal takes 30 cents plus a percentage. So you're only getting like $4.40 or whatever it is. You wouldn't want to use this, because this would give you a solid $5. So you're actually losing out on 40 cents of that $5 that you're going to be paying taxes on, which is really dumb. You don't want to do that. But, I mean, at least it'll give you a general of, like, hey, look, you know, you want to go back and look at it, see how much you made, what did I do this with? This is something you can use, and this will be a bar graph, and this will be a list of everything. So let's say you have, you can do the bar graph, like, daily, monthly.
Did your bar go down?
And that's how that's going to work. Chat history, same deal.
Oh,
go through and look at all
your
chat.
No, it should still be working.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll give you a really easy way to eyeball how much money
you made. Because I just typed in GC, and it still hasn't showed up.
Just because it'll keep
track of it. Give it some time. It may be on a cooldown.
The financial history is going to come in when I get the web page built.
Better yet, I'm actually going to refresh the bot right now. I'm going to close it and bring it back up. It may be because it's been on for like 2 days.
And I want ProBot to be free. That's the idea.
It does need a break from time to time.
I'm going to have to take a portion of the donations you get.
Be right back, guys, with the bot. I'm going to be up. The bot in chat is going to go down.
And I'm not entirely sure if I have to pay. Hey, Salom, how you doing, buddy? And I don't know if I'm going to have to pay when I skim the top, if I'm going to have to pay a transaction fee. Because if I have to pay a transaction fee, then I need to pass it on to you. Which really sucks, because if someone gives you a dollar, then I'm taking money and PayPal's taking money, and it just gets ugly. You know, the dollar just isn't worth donating. But what we might be able to do is set a minimum donation, so people can't just donate a dollar. They could actually donate, you know, say $2 or $3. Instead, you know, just have a minimum donation. I'm thinking that's probably the best way to do this. But anyway, so chats, you'll be able to pull up chats. So if you ever, let's say someone said something stupid in chat and you want to prove it to them, you can bring this up and you can say, hey, look, this is what you did. This is why you're banned. You know, and make it easy to search. So you can pull up days and everything else. Debug, this is obvious. This will be just where it posts all the stuff. Like this, what you're looking at here, this is all, you know, settings and stuff. But you'll have other things, you know, all the stuff in the background. So if I ever need to pull a log because it isn't working for you, this is what I'm going to be able to see. So we can actually easily see what's going on with the bot. Support, this will be a contact us and a live support page. Pretty basic. It's just going to, you know, just like the bot where you can actually get in here and get live support from someone. And I have someone that actually is going to be doing that for us. So you'll have live support a lot of the time between me and them. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is to it. And I forgot one last thing. All of these little boxes that you see, they're all going to be able to popped out of this bot. So it's actually going to, like, if you, let's say you wanted to move this, but you wanted to see your stream status, or better yet, your current giveaway. Let's say you just wanted to see your current giveaway, and you didn't want to see the rest of the bot. Well, what you'll be able to do is there'll be a button here. You click on the button, this thing will actually pop
what
out
up,
of
Scott
the
Plants?
Box. And you can just keep up just a small little window up in the corner of your screen or something. So the whole idea here is that I'm going
to Scott, what's up, man?
And you want to be able to, you know, there's certain things on this bot that you're going to want to see all the time. Like chat. Like with having to look at DeepBot and having to have this whole fucking thing open annoys the shit out.
I passed out.
And so I just want to maybe just move the chat, make the chat resizable, put it up on one of my other windows.
My guy passed out. I'm just like chilling. Outside the cave.
Do you revive?
You know what you can even do with that?
Yeah, you wake back up, but you just like pass out for just a few seconds.
You can even have it for an overlay if you wanted to. So that's kind of the idea, is that everything's going to be able to pop out, everything's going to be an overlay, and the idea here is to reward users. But yeah, so that's basically the bot, man. That's what I have so far. I'm working on right now. I'll show you what I'm working on.
I finally have a bed now.
in your little cave. Hold on. Right now, what I'm doing is I'm working on the connection process. So this is IRC connection that you're looking at here. This right here is actually the full of connect.
Scott.
And when you hit the button to connect, this is what's going to go on. And
hello.
Then you have down here. You'll have connections and it starts.
All right. I can hear you. I think. Hello.
Not interested in.
Hello?
But yeah.
So right.
This is,
I gotta turn you up one more.
Let me show you what the graph is gonna look like. I can bring that over here.
Yeah, turn me all the way up, baby.
Dude, I got you up to 15. You're like lower than everyone else. I think this might be because of Ark.
So that's more or less what the graph is.
Probably. Dude. I'm about to get it.
Fucking. I've been on since 7:51 last night.
Before I shut this bad boy down and go back to the
Blood Crow took a nap and came back. And we have a server now, but we are trying to wait for it to load up.
Hey, Crow, you're up to 33 out of 50 now.
Or even ideas. I'm open to ideas if you have some.
Depending on, like, where you get the server from.
He got it from game servers.
It will take, like,
a
while.
Blood Crow, man. I hope it
should be up, basically.
That's literally what I'm going for. I didn't.
Yeah, it should be up because he's already throughout the IP for it.
Yeah, we got the IP for it. We're waiting for it to show up.
Well, actually, you know, Blood, I'm gonna let everyone test it. I mean, that's the whole beauty of this. Kind of like, you know, I want this to be open for everyone. I'm not gonna share the source, because I don't want people stealing the source and just trying to resell my box.
You might have to play around the server settings.
But, you know, what it is going to be,
What up, Evan Bomb?
Yeah, no, it's bad. Depot is awful, isn't it? I'm fucking not a fan, dude. I played with it, like, I wasn't about to spend money on it. And I went and got the hacked version, which is, you know, works, dude. It does. But I don't like it, dude. I didn't like it. I was like, well, you know, I'll check out the hacked version, see if it's something I like, and I'll go buy it. You know, I don't mind spending money. I'm a software developer. People need money. I get it. Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah, for some reason,
you know,
on Blood Crows, it's got that little red
it, like,
dude on it.
This is just awful. I mean, there's some things I like about it,
but on your ski,
really
it doesn't.
Terrible.
Little red
so what
deep.
I did is
what
I
are you talking about?
It.
Well, you know, on your gray sidebar, how it has that
now,
white twitch at the top?
Forgive me because it's not all. I didn't really actually need to change
it's
all
it's got a red ghost on it.
Else, but this is essentially deep bot.
Oh, yeah.
All decompiled.
You may be signed in, but not signed. I'm signed in.
What they were doing, and a lot of the code. I mean, like.
All right, I
you just may be signed
things.
Off
everything
at the time.
Has an action.
You may
everything
need to refresh my stream
right?
In order
right.
To see
why?
Yourself signed in.
There's a better way to do this. You can set up your own.
I don't
like,
know.
I mean, this is shit like this.
Just.
Threading,
I mean, it's just on my channel.
Your own threading method, and it works just fine. You don't need to have.
But it should be showing you active in
the
chat. Are you gaining?
At the bottom.
Are you gaining game cartridges over time?
Yeah.
It's dumb, and I think.
Well, you're still fine. You're
so
still in.
Overhead. It's just got shit tons of background workers running at all times. You don't really need to do that. Yeah, and the idea of having to pay for a fucking IRC bot. I mean, literally, it's an IRC bot, dude. It's not that like this code here.
Oh my god.
Here, I pulled
what?
From a free IRC
that's
bot, and now I'm
freaking
kind of
huge.
Because you need to
what?
Do that. But I mean, this. It's
the game?
The game.
I mean, this all
oh,
the
but
game.
Don't
it's
worry, they have a low memory and a
4
gig memory
on
settings
your
on top of.
I have to make space.
Huh?
You can do it my drives are full.
You know, again, I will have to.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it, like for low memory and all sorts of shit, like, it's funny. For
but,
like low end
I mean,
users and shit, they finally
not,
have access for
doing.
Everyone.
Kind of
and they're making Linux and Mac
really
servers for this.
Right
like, they're going
so,
like multi platform for this
it,
game
if
already.
If it makes me a little money,
and they're already talking about outrageous spoilers
yeah,
that
but
no one can get
anyway,
to just yet.
That's the whole general of this mod.
Hey, yeah. Blade Crow, while you've been asleep, I heard
really
some really good news about the game.
I don't know, reported that.
We'll be able to tame megalodons and take them underwater
well, anyway,
into underwater cave systems.
So how big is
hopefully
your
you have a snorkel and stuff like that by then.
Fucking hopefully, I know, right? Let's look. Can I make a snorkel yet? No. Apparently I can still make a spyglass, but at the level they give it to you, you can't make it at all. You can't make it. It's impossible. Why? You can't harvest crystal yet.
That with a question or something.
Oh, but at level 25, you can make the better equipment. And I have metal.
I like that. You can make a paintbrush.
No, I was when you were talking about getting the server yesterday. Oh, okay. Yeah, I was going to say, you know, because if you start inviting people from the stream, I get to see people going dumbass on on your base or something. Like, oh, hey.
You put because you get your desktop all figured out.
You're the best ever.
Yeah. My tech buddy who...
Got big balls, man. I would not let people
basically ran his business. He ran all his shit on the computer.
Really
when he opened it up, he found a 24 prong connected to the power supply unit. The clip that actually holds it firmly in place, that's broken. It's gone.
Over 8K?
Then he found my 8 prong cable that was completely tangled in all of the cables inside the case. It was like he said it was wrapped inside all of the cables. So I buy power like hid the fucking thing on purpose.
What I'm gonna do is that I really
and then on top of that,
randomly,
the power supply cable that was in it wasn't giving it enough juice. There's only one line running to it from the power, so that's why it kept dripping out.
So you're gonna be able
and
to
there were lots,
that I like to watch,
if not all of the
like
screws on the motherboard were actually
so
loose and not even set
let's
in.
Let's say I want to do, because how I...
So,
basically,
yeah.
And then after
so
him,
way to
I
go
Captain
fucking
Richard,
I buy power. I'm only sending my rig back now if parts fry out or break.
And so the idea
I will send my rig
say, you know,
to him for a look over if something fries out or for a test.
And then I wanted to do Bod and then Captain
yeah,
Richard,
Key, that's why I would much rather just
schedule.
Buy the parts
so,
and build it myself.
Every 2 hours or whatever.
Well, I didn't expect to have this much of a problem because I spent $2,200 on my rig.
And if, like, let's say that hoster isn't on,
and
that
I already sent it back to him five times. Each time I send it back is 1 month of me not having it. 1 week of travel there, 1 to 2 weeks for them to test it, and a week for it to travel back, ground. And it's $60 a pop for me to send it from Ohio to California. If I wanted to ship it overnight, they want $300 in mail. And I was like, no. Can't do it. I mean, yeah, I'm a streamer, but I've got a fucking laptop. And that's the scariest thing, is having to resort to a laptop. For games like this, I wouldn't be streaming them. I'd be streaming Super Nintendo, like Earthbound, and like Prison Architect, and maybe World of Warships at 10 to 15 frames a second. Like, that's the scariest thing ever. Hobo ate my taco. Yes, I paid $2,200 for a pre-built. I have an i7-4790. Basically, in July, this was almost top of the line. I got an AMD R9-290. That's my GPU. 1,000-watt power supply. 32 gigs of DDR4 RAM. It's a rip jaw.
Barely missed. Son of a bitch.
That's actually not bad for a pre-built.
I also have, obviously, I've got a water cooler on the CPU. It's completely sealed water cooler with fan push power support. Let's see, I've got 7 fans. 3 of which I added myself. I added a VGA fan. It's just 2 fans. You just plug them in. I got them off of Amazon for like $5. I bought 2 of them, originally thinking I had a heat issue. Then I went out of my way. I have 3 monitors. I buy power for what I bought. Gave me a keyboard and a mouse, so I didn't have to worry about that shit. I bought a Logitech C920 webcam, 1080p widescreen. But I also purchased, with the help of the community, when we thought it was electrical and not heat.
Well, if you want, you could jump on and play some World
Warships. Uninterruptible power supply,
done,
APC brand is
can
amazing.
Group up? Is that even an option?
Oh, Blood Crow is saying that they had the wrong port.
Wrong port.
For the server.
What?
On the control panel.
Port in 100. 01 for the port.
Okay. Which one are we adding now, Bloodcrow?
What the bloody fuck? Did you see that shit? Oh, I got so lucky. I got so lucky.
Hey, Game Key, did I ever send you a pic of my case?
No.
I finally got.
No. Also, guys, I did not get a full case. iBuyPower does not deal in full cases. They deal in, like, what is it, mid-range cases?
No, they have full tower cases.
Come on, turn, bitch. Turn B.
Well, when I bought this one, there wasn't a full. From what me and Bloodcrow could see.
Oh, I'm going to get fucked.
Granted, it was probably like $200 extra than what my budget was for a full case, too.
Well, it wouldn't have been $200 extra. It would be about like $115 or so. That's how much they run for retail-wise.
Well, it's iBuyPower. They marked up a lot of shit, and then they didn't bother to even put it together right. Guys, I also dealt with iBuyPower for 9 months on fixing this issue. It took me sending my computer to an offhand computer company. This is a trusted friend of mine who's been running his own computer company for a few years now while he's been in college. He's got a full ride scholarship to Youngstown State University for computer programming and development. So he's like on the fast track to success. He also supports the hackathons. So if you guys want to give a shout out and a thank you to my personal tech that I prefer to use now, his name is Joe Dunko. I'm going to say tweet or Facebook him a big thank you for fixing our big rig. And here is his name to go tweet and Facebook.
Oh, that's funny. That is hilarious.
But the, you there, Anthony?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, dude, I think I figured out what's going on with the server. They had the wrong fucking port put in there. So, I'm checking it again. It pulled up for me.
Oh, that's funny. Have a good one, boss.
Alright, guys, so yeah, I think I figured out what was wrong with the bot. Or, not the bot.
Like, I saw, I actually figured out what the port was, so.
I'm back in the configuration. Okay, I think I figured out what's going on with the server. They had the wrong fucking port put in there. So,
they got to be doing this.
I'm checking it again. It pulled up for me. Now it's not again. So I don't know what the fuck's going on. Like I saw, I actually figured out what the port was. So I'm back in the configuration file, and I'm checking for the port again and see if they've changed it. They got to be doing this.
I'm actually going to make this a command right now.
As you hear that AMD is about to announce their next biggest GPU.
Yeah, the 300 series, yeah.
Whoop. Whoop-dee-doo right now. AMD fucking laughed at me. They didn't want to fucking help me, so I don't care at this point. After this AMD card...
that AMD is about to...
What's up, Daniel?
Announce their next biggest GPU.
That was 300 series.
Oh.
Whoop-dee-doo
right now. AMD.
I mean, eventually I might put a password on the server once I remember out how to do that.
After this AMD card.
So that way, you know.
I'm hearing myself, guys.
That'll be awesome. Yes. So.
Oh, no wonder. No wonder. I had Bloodcrow stream up. No wonder.
There we go. Damn it, the server pops up and it goes away. It pops up and it goes away.
Really?
Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. I think it's up. I think it's actually up, up. Oh shit.
I don't suppose Dagrin isn't here today. What time is
it? Oh shit, guys.
Alright, I'm gonna leave this server.
How is it that I figured out why their server's not working before they do? Because I got the wrong fucking port listed. What the hell? Doesn't matter. Kyle? It's up and running now.
You send me the info? Or
no,
is it
no.
Or is it still mm-hmm. the same?
It's in my chat. Oh. The port, instead of it being 21,000, it's 21,001 at the very end. They had it off by one number incorrectly. And that's what I had to do. I had to actually go through the configuration files and look through and see what the FTP was and other stuff. And then I started looking and I noticed that one of them wasn't matching up for the ports. The IP was fine. The port was wrong. And I found the port and it was like, bam, right there.
Is
like,
this
there
the We Are right the Community?
There. We Are the Community. That's what I named it for right now.
Okay, so I should get rid of these other two forever then.
Keep nah. VDONs, get rid of the other one. Keep VDONs, get rid of the other one. You know, VDONs can be something we can get on there and goof around with. If there's ever a way that he can spawn shit in, we can use his server to spawn stuff in and, like, you know, do whatever, test stuff out. While this is loading,
is
I'm
not currently playing on any game server.
I'll be right back.
Blood Crow?
I'm loading in. We're going to see if it's working. I'll be right back. We got the game server up.
Oh, it says 3 out of 40. I know. Be right back, guys. Look, we're trying to load in. What up, Hitama? We're trying to load in, man.
Oh my god, buddy. Hey. Are you eating this or no? No? Here. You eat it.
Pick it up. All right, I'm back. Hold on. I gotta sit down. Let me sit down.
I'm back.
Let me get situated. All right, we're gonna see. Never mind. Fuck it. Keep me to the menu.
Yeah, it keeps popping up and going away. Really? Yeah, it keeps popping up and disconnecting.
Alright. That's what it's doing for me. Okay. Because I got the wrong freaking ports on here is the problem.
Really?
But yeah. I mean...
Again?
It's trying... You gotta think, man. The game server is like probably confused. It's trying to use two different ports to play. So we're connecting on one and then it's jumping around to the other, so...
Oh my god, so you're gonna have to let them know, like, hey, your ports are all fucked up for the game.
Mm-hmm.
God damn it.
That sucks.
I got in. I joined off LUT.
What?
All backwards.
Really?
Yeah. Going off the left. Huh. Try joining off me.
Alright, hold on a second. How long have you been logged in? Just for a few seconds, I guess, disturbed?
Yeah.
It right, pops up and then goes away, but I'm connecting to it. I'm attempting to connect right now.
Alright, disturbed. I'm just going to try to connect off of you. I have to get a ticket sent in because it can't be doing this.
Yeah, especially if we bump it finally all the way up to 70.
Yeah. I mean, if we start getting, I mean, it'll be fixed before then, dude. This is just the server initially startup. I mean, once we do this, man.
Yeah, even my loading bar keeps disappearing, like the little one in the bottom right corner. It kept going through cycling, and then it just disappeared and popped back up, and it's frozen now. I don't know if I'm going to even be able to play on it.
You'll be able to play on it. Don't worry.
I hope so.
Don't freak out. Don't freak out.
You don't understand, Bloodcrow. I've been waiting since 6 o'clock this morning. Oh my god, my computer just crashed. No, the game... My video driver crashed. Are you kidding me?